Can I start all the way?
Go ahead.
All right. Good morning, actually. Good morning, class. Today I'm going to be talking about The Emperor's New Clothes. And who here read the story The Emperor's New Clothes? So everybody. Okay. The audience, So today I'm going to be talking about the five senses of this in the story. So first of all, I'm going to be talking about hear, and I'm going to be saying a couple sentences or like what's it called? Things that I wrote for the story. So for the first one is here. So the emperor was asked for more money for fabrics, but the money was forgotten of in the weaver's pockets. So example of that in the story is the weavers kept the money. They didn't use it for any fabrics. And for taste, I wrote, the bitter words in the minister's mouth baffled him. So, for example, what that means is when the minister said, heaven have mercy, and he said, can it be that I am a fool? He wasn't sure if he was up for the job or if he was wise or anything like that, so he thought he was stupid. And the third one is touch. As the emperor put on the new clothes with the finest fabrics, almost feeling like a cobweb, the swindlers, they told him that they made his clothes out of the finest fabrics, so therefore it felt like there was nothing there because it was made of the finest fabrics. And for the fourth one, I put smell. The emperor's house carried the aroma of lit candles throughout the night. So the example of that is the swindlers burned through 6 candles to make it seem like they were working on the clothes all night and that they were finishing it up. And for C, I put, as the child focused his vision on the emperor, he noticed he was in his trousers as white as snow because the emperor wasn't wearing any clothes. So what I went over was the five senses: hear, taste, touch, smell, and see. And each one had their own sentence on the story. Thank you.